with 25 losses, 17 draws and only 12 wins, Kerala Blasters averaged 0.98 points per match in the last 3 seasons. By looking at these stats, nobody can say this is the performance of one of the biggest clubs in the Asia in terms of the fan base. So how club like Kerala Blasters, who made it to the 2 finals in the first 3 seasons, gone downhill? Kerala Blasters came closest to winning the ISL trophy in the very first season against ATK, but the header from Mohammed Rafiq in the injury time breaks the hearts of millions of Blasters fans. Next season, they were nowhere near to finish in the top 4, with only 13 points, they finished bottom in the league. In 2016, Blasters bounced back and reached the final against ATK, but again luck was not in the favour of Blasters. After 120 minutes of a tough match, ATK won the trophy on penalties. After 2016, the downfall of Kerala Blasters began. Despite investing heavily in Wes Brown, Ian Hume, Dimitar Berbatov and many more, they still go as far as 6th position in the 4th season. That is the story of Kerala Blasters for next 2 seasons. They invest heavily in players and change almost the whole squad, which cause instability, lack of chemistry and leadership in the club. The instability did not stop at players. Since 2014, Kerala Blasters has appointed 9 managers in 6 years, the most by any team in the ISL. Some of the more consistent sides, Bengaluru, Goa and Chennaiyin FC, has made the least number of managerial changes, which has helped them in the long term as they are the 3 teams with the highest win percentage of 56.45%, 47.22% and 38.31% respectively. However, ATK was the only exception who won the 3 ISL trophies despite making 6 managerial changes. It is quite evident that decisions made by the Blasters management have not gone well. Former assistant coach of the South Indian team, Trevor Morgan, slammed the Blasters management and he said, "It is a difficult thing in the ISL as it has a very small season and after maybe 4-5 games, when the team does not do well, the first thing they do is remove the coach. The coach had brought the 90% of the players and when a new coach comes in, he has to play rest of the season with those players who he did not select. So it is a very difficult. It is really down to people who own the club. They have to have a faith in the person who they are employing. Maybe longer term contract will help the clubs," he said that in an interview with Goal.com. Before the start of the 2019-20 season, another poor decision was taken by the Kerala Blasters management when the main man of the Blasters defense sidelined for a whole season due to an ACL injury. They did not make high caliber replacement for Sandesh Jingan. So the weakness in the defense showed in the 2019-20 campaign, in which they conceded the third most number of goals, 32, and finished on the 7th position. After the awful season, Blasters management sacked Alko Shatori. After the sacking, when he was asked about his role in the recruitment of players, he said, "I believe that for a club to have a success in the long run, the manager and club need to have a cooperation in the planning and scouting of the team. Last season, I did not have any to say in the Indian recruitment. I was hoping to shape the team according to my liking next season, but I won't get my chance now." So after 3 disappointing seasons, the management decided to build a new strategy at club. As a part of this, the Blasters appointed Karolis Kinkis as a sporting director on 15 March 2020. Karolis previously worked as a sporting director for a Lithuanian club, FK Suduva, for 5 years. During his tenure at Suduva, Karolis played an integral role in team selection and internal leadership management. Under his guidance, the club won the league in 2017-18 and 2019. Also in 2019, the club made history as they qualified for the following year's UEFA Champions League. At Kerala Blasters, Karolis' first decision was the appointment of Kibio Vicuna as a new manager for 2 years. Karolis successfully started to implement a new philosophy at Blasters. He decided to have a ground-up rebuild at the club, and as a part of that, Karolis went for a young Indian players in the transfer market. Nishu Kumar, a 23-year-old left-back, signed for a long 4-year contract. Along with Nishu, he was able to sign other youngsters including Gibson Singh, Rohit Kumar, Ritvik Das, Piyutia and Prab Sukhan Gill. Also, he gave a contract extension to Sahal and Rahul KP until 2025. in Foreign Department, he extended the contract of Sergio Sidorica for 1 year and signed Vicente Gomez on a 3-year deal. However, despite signing these players, Blasters still struggling this season. One of the biggest reasons for the poor performance this season is the inability to create goal scoring chances despite having the majority of possession. The defense is another area Blasters really needs to work on, as they conceded the joint most number of goals, 11, with East Bengal. Kerala Blasters need to get a good results in the next 2-3 games before the top 4 position become too far for them.